Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's define standard conditions.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In order to do science, we must do experiments. And when we do these experiments, the data we collect will allow us to do calculations. Any relevant calculations may depend on certain environmental factors, like temperature and pressure, and sometimes humidity. And these parameters can have a range of values. We can do experiments at very low pressures, or even zero pressure if in a vacuum, or we can do experiments in highly pressurized environments. We can do experiments at very low temperatures, near absolute zero, or we can do experiments at very high temperatures, using a flame or even under explosive conditions. But many or most of our experiments are done in open atmosphere under what we can refer to as standard conditions. These are standard sets of conditions for experimental measurements set by the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, or IUPAC, that allow easy comparisons to be made between data sets all over the world. The first set we will discuss is called Standard Temperature and Pressure, abbreviated as STP. This refers to a temperature of 0 Celsius, or 273.15 Kelvin, and a pressure of 100 kilopascals, or precisely 1 bar. Another set, called Standard Ambient Temperature and Pressure, abbreviated as SATP, sets the temperature at 25 degrees Celsius, or 298.15 Kelvin, which is roughly room temperature, and pressure, once again, is set at 100 kilopascals, or 1 bar. So the difference between these two sets is the difference between the freezing point of water and room temperature. Sometimes when people refer to standard conditions, they mean standard state conditions. This includes a temperature of 25 Celsius and a pressure equal to atmospheric pressure at sea level, which by definition is 1 atmosphere. This can also be expressed as 760 millimeters mercury or 101.325 kilopascals, which is extremely close to the pressure previously discussed for STP. Standard state conditions can also refer to concentration, more specifically to solution concentrations of precisely 1 molar for any solute. The point of these sets is that so much science is done at the ambient temperature and pressure of a normal laboratory, and noting this allows us to make simplifications to our equations that allow for easier calculations, and also allows for the compilation of standardized tables of data that we can plug into our equations. However, the idea of a standard laboratory temperature and pressure is inevitably culture-bound, since different regions of the world differ greatly in climate, altitude, and access to heating or cooling technology. So this must be kept in mind when communicating science amongst one another. In the end, when looking at tabulated constants and reported data, be sure to note the conditions listed to put them in the proper context. And be sure to make note of the conditions in your own laboratory when doing experiments.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.